Hi everybody, my name is Barney Manrix and I'm a co-founder of Vega Protocol, which is a platform for trading of smart financial products. I'll explain a bit about what they are in a minute. My background is in the financial services industry, so I spent the first 12 years of my career working in investment banks, exchanges, buy-side, sell-side financial services, starting off in sort of the larger organizations and the big projects, and then moving towards innovation, and finally sort of ending up here building a disruptive blockchain-based platform. So a little bit of history to explain what Vega is. The sort of cryptocurrency revolution, if you like, the sort of blockchain revolution, started with Bitcoin in 2008. And in the Bitcoin white paper, Satoshi Nakamoto wrote about and designed a system that allowed people to move money around and to have a balance of money anywhere on Earth, to trade the money digitally, and to do so without having to trust any central institution or bank. And this was a great innovation and something that opened up all sorts of possibilities. But of course, the financial system and the world doesn't stop with money and cash. So not that long afterwards, people started thinking about smart contracts. And obviously, Ethereum is the big one in the smart contract game. And sometime around 2014, the Ethereum white paper came out and was talking about moving computation onto the blockchain and opening up the ability to run decentralized organizations, decentralized products, decentralized applications, all on the blockchain. And in fact, if you look at the Ethereum white paper, you'll find that it talks about insurance products, it talks about derivatives, and it talks about all kinds of exciting uses for the blockchain. However, if you fast forward to 2018 and take a look at what the Ethereum blockchain can really do, you notice some problems if you start trying to do derivatives. If you want to run a derivatives platform, you need to do things like margin calculations and risk calculations. If you want to run a trading platform, you need to match trades, and you need to match potentially hundreds or thousands of trades a second, not 7 or 25 trades a second. So, you know, there are some shortcomings when it comes to financial markets and products of a general purpose blockchain like Ethereum's. And so that was really the sort of starting point for Vega. We started to think, what if instead of a central, general purpose blockchain, what if we created a special purpose blockchain, a second layer solution just for financial products and trading, that sacrifices some of the applications of the smart contract platform in order to focus on things like performance and the ability to do risk calculations and the ability to provide a lower latency trading experience. And that's really where Vega and the concept of smart products, that's really where that was born. So what's the vision of Vega? Well, the vision of Vega is to take the financial markets, the financial markets which are incredibly opaque and which are incredibly asymmetrical. You know, the people who run exchanges and markets are a very small group of large institutions and wealthy institutions in a small number of countries in the world. And those people control and are gatekeepers to the marketplace for financial products. And that means that they decide what products you can trade, and they decide how much fees and how much costs they're going to charge on top of that when you actually want to access those products. So one thing we think is that these markets should be for everyone. If you're a farmer in the UK or in Amsterdam or in America, you can lock in a price for your crops now and avoid the risk of the price changing. Or you can use weather derivatives to hedge the risk that your crops will fail. But if you're a farmer in Africa or India or another third world country, you may find those products are not available. You may not even have a bank account. So you're exposed to all of these risks. You know, a freak flood or a bad year or a change in prices could leave you seriously out of pocket and cause damage to your family and your business. So one of the things we think is that these markets should be available to anyone who wants them, and these products should be global and universal and accessible to everyone. And the second thing we think is really key is the idea of liquidity and pricing. Because these markets currently are controlled, and if you want to access them, you don't go to the source, you don't get into the order book, you go via a commercial banker who goes by an investment banker who then goes to the exchange. That means that you're just layering fees and costs We think that that's not necessary, and in fact we think that blockchain technology can allow us to improve the liquidity for everyone and give fair and transparent pricing for everyone. So that's really the motivation for us with Vega, to take the concepts of blockchain and build a second layer solution for financial products that allows them to be built and traded efficiently and well in a decentralized manner. So, I'm introducing Vega Protocol. Vega is a end-to-end protocol for trading, margining, and settling financial products. It includes a high-performance decentralized exchange. Like I said, Vega's built as a second layer solution using a proof-of-stake blockchain built on Tendermint, which sees 1 second block times and over 2,000 transactions a second in our proof of concept already. That's much, much higher than Ethereum and much, much more suitable for trading. We offer safe margin trading as well. That means that you can't lose more than you put in, and the network calculates your margin requirements for each trade to make sure that the network and the other participants are also protected against you defaulting. We can settle across blockchains. Because we're a second layer solution and because we're not our own cryptocurrency, we can settle between Bitcoin and Ethereum and ERC20 and other blockchains in future, which allows us to build smart products that actually settle the crypto assets of today, but also the crypto assets of the future, no matter which technology ends up winning. We have smart products. I've mentioned these before, and smart products are absolutely core to what we're doing. One of the reasons that we're able to offer this high-performance margined environment is because we have given up the flexible smart contracts of something like Ethereum for smart products which are built on an API of financial building blocks. So an API of concepts like, you know, exchanges, like options, like futures. And those concepts can be combined together in many ways to create different products, multi-leg strategies, effectively almost any financial product. And that smart product language allows us to have a system within Vega that can calculate the margin efficiently for any trade done on Vega. And finally, market making. This is really, really important. A market is no good with no prices. And if anyone here has tried trading on some of the decentralized exchanges that have been launched already, one of the problems that many of them face is that for many of the assets, there is very little liquidity. The prices will be very wide, there may be very few trades. And that's really not particularly useful in a market. So, you know, one of the core innovations of Vega is that we've tokenized liquidity. We've actually created a marketplace for liquidity on Vega. And that means that market makers are rewarded for providing liquidity, and they're rewarded more for providing liquidity where it's needed. So if you have a high liquidity, highly traded, you know, Ethereum Bitcoin market, then the fees and the rewards for market maker might be very low on that market, which means that the cost of trading will be very low. But equally, if you have a much less liquid instrument, the fees will be higher to attract market makers into the market, and that will mean you can always get a price, but at the cost of slightly higher trading fees. And this pricing is dynamic. This means that every market on Vega will be competing with every other market for the liquidity. So liquidity should naturally go where it's needed. Another slide on how we do that. So market makers in Vega place a stake on the network, and that stake is placed in the base currency of the market, and that means that they're committed to providing prices 24/7. If they do provide those prices, they receive a share of the trading fees along with the other market makers on that network. And if they don't provide prices, then the stake that they've placed is penalized, some of it is confiscated from them as a penalty for failing to meet their commitment. Vega itself, it's worth noting, we take no fees. We're building a completely open platform. It's decentralized, and it's, you know, absolutely core principle that we're not sat in the middle taking fees or controlling the network. So this has been a really, really quick overview. We only had a sort of 10-minute slot here for this talk, so there's loads more detail I can get into if you want to talk to me after the talk. But just a quick update on where we are now. We have a working proof of concept running. On some nodes distributed around the world that we're running. By the end of July, we'll have a full prototype and we'll move that onto the testnet. And sometime in August, probably late August at this point, we will move into a mainnet alpha, sort of privately selected participants testing on the mainnet. And then towards December at the end of the year, we'll roll out our sort of into a beta stage. Into next year, we'll be rolling out more features on the platform. That's been a really, really quick overview of Vega.
Thank you, everyone.